spending 3 nights solo camping. I'm traveling a distance of about 16 to 18 kilometers a day. 3 campsites, lots of portages. I need this. I need the solitude, I need the challenge. Come along with me, I think you're gonna enjoy this one. I'm ready for the adventure. I had a very good night's sleep. Got over 8 hours, probably around 8.5 hours of solid sleep. Got up twice to pee, which is good for me. I was chugging the water yesterday. I was peeing like I'd have to stop between portages 2 or 3 times to pee, but that's okay. It's better to be more hydrated than dehydrated. So anyways, good night's sleep. Wake up to nice mist on the lake. Some joke meal. I'm gonna get up and out of here probably within the next hour. No rush. Just pack up leisurely and head straight across around a cove. And then I'm gonna be back into the Petawawa River. So the Petawawa River emptied into Misty Lake, and then it continues on the other side, which is kind of cool. So I'm chilly here, sitting in the shade, but out there the sun's come out today. In the weather forecast, when I was looking for these 4 days that I'll be here, today was the only day that was full sun. Yesterday was clouds and sun. Today's full sun. Tomorrow is clouds and sun. Today's supposed to be right around 80 degrees, and tomorrow's supposed to be like 86-ish Fahrenheit. So, yeah, we'll see how it goes. There's a nice wind. I can see the waves moving pretty good. Yeah, good morning. Bit chilly. Got down probably 5 Celsius last night.
I'm right here on this end site by itself, and what I need to do is paddle across the lake back this way, up around this hump by these 2 campsites, and head east, excuse me, through the Big Misty. Finally, I have an 850 portage into the Petawawa. Then I am pretty solid going still, a little 150. There says there's a, in high water you can skip this 155, so we'll see. Another one down through all this meandering grassy part into Grassy Bay, and then up into White Trout Lake. And I'm not going to go too far up into White Trout, because the next day, tomorrow, I have to come down this way. So ideally I'm going to camp at one of those 3 sites right there.
There's the beauty all loaded up, ready to go.
I never thought after yesterday's windiest day ever that Misty Lake would ever be calm. But here we are. So much warmer already in the sun. It's welcomed right now, but later on today we'll see how I feel.
Big old froggy. Not sure if it's a green frog or a bullfrog. If it's a green frog, it's the biggest one I've ever seen. And if it's a bullfrog, it's kind of small.
Yeah, he is a bullfrog. I really like frogs. My favorite. I used to have, hear him? He's pissed. Woo, see ya. I used to have tree frogs as pets.
some old logging remnants, big old cutters, huge blades. See this stuff every now and then in the park here. Kind of cool.
So when it comes time to do a portage, my removable yoke is super easy to put on and off. It's got these knobs where you can tension it, but I don't even find I need it. All I do is I put tape on either side to mark where I need to put the yoke on and to have it a little bit grip. And I've got tape on the underside of the hooks. So all I do is hook it on one side, literally squeeze the boat together, pop that down, and she's on there. Now that's not gonna fall off at all.
That yoke is made of carbon fiber. It's super lightweight, super durable, really easy to use. At first I didn't know about taking it on and off, but it's the way to go for this for sure. I measured at home 19 and a half inches back from that first thwart on either side, and I found that that's the optimal balance spot. The last trip in Tomogamy, I picked that boat up on the way and went and did that trip. So I didn't have the yoke in the proper spot at all. I had the tape was cockeyed because I didn't have a measuring tape to measure it, so they weren't both the same. So I threw everything off, but this is working much better. I've got an 850 meter portage. Ba-bam. Well, that sign you saw is coming from the other way. I'm at the end of the portage now, so I'm going from Misty to Petawawa. It was a rough portage, actually. Lots of muddy spots and up and down, but not too bad. I did it single carry again, yay, single carry Joe. And I'm gonna take a break. That's what I'm gonna do. Snack some water. I'm gonna have four raisins. Oh, three raisins. Oh, I'm so stuffed. You guys know what you can do with a raisin box? Fold in all the top after it's empty. Fancy. I guess that's that. This section of the Petawawa is gorgeous. Look what I found. Somebody made a little paddle. That's kind of cool.
It's light wood, but it does not smell like cedar. I'm guessing basswood. Pretty cool, man. Oh, damn it. Not good. Are you okay?
If anyone watching this made that and left it there,
This is the 195 low water portage from the Petawawa to the Petawawa going downstream. If you made that, I'd be interested in hearing what kind of wood it is. And very cool.
I was paddling behind those guys for a good 10 minutes, real slow. I caught up to him and I almost touched his butt with my nose in my canoe. Lots of animals today. I saw a rabbit at my campsite, and a red squirrel followed me along the shore for quite some time, hopping along the rocks. What else? Oh, a seagull dive-bombed me a few times, then pooed right next to me, peed and pooed, and I saw it hit the water. It was a bunch of it. Lots of animal action this trip. It's awesome.
I'd be lying if I said I wasn't tired. It's 12:15 now. I've been going since 7. So just over 5 hours today. I've just completed my last portage for the day, which is cool. Not too many today, maybe 5 or so, and they've all been relatively small. So this last one, I timed myself as a 200 meter from Petawawa River into Grassy Bay. It took me 4 minutes, single carry. That's pretty good. Happy with that. I'm basically at the lake that I need to camp on. This Grassy Bay turns into White Trout. Like I said earlier, I'm not gonna go too far up. Let me show you my plan on the map. So now I'm just at the end of that 200 meter portage you can see there. Basically, if I orient the map the way that I'm going, all I have to do is go in there. And technically, I'm sure that that's a Grassy Bay campsite, not a White Trout Lake campsite. So then I've got to paddle there. So here, there, there, and I'm gonna camp on 1, 2, or 3 of those. I am gonna go check out that one campsite there just to see how it is. If nobody's around, maybe I'll take it. I'm not 100% if they would categorize that as Trout Lake or Grassy. I think Grassy, but we'll see. If it's a spectacular site, maybe I'm staying there. But as it's in a marsh, seeing how it's in a marsh, I don't imagine it being too good. Well, this settles it. I'm staying here. This is home for night two. This is a beauty site, man. Huge open areas, some flat shaded areas back there where I can pitch my tent. There's a nice big rock, and I heard a ton of bullfrogs to my left. I haven't seen anyone this whole trip. I highly doubt anybody's gonna come to this site that they booked this site for today. And if they do, I'll leave and I'll paddle on down, that way. Counterintuitive to where I'm supposed to be going tomorrow, because I'm supposed to be going that way tomorrow. So I have a big day tomorrow, my biggest day so far, my most kilometers, high mileage day, and I really don't want to canoe 2-3 clicks down that way just to have to do it again, backtrack this tomorrow morning. So yeah, if somebody comes, I will give this site up for them, no problem.
Got the canoe tied up, just floating in the water, Bill Mason style.
I found a feather, I think it's a duck feather. It's iridescent when I switch it in the light. There's like a teal, bluish color. So I don't know if it's from a blueing teal or not, but I'm gonna bring it home for emerald.
I'm gonna go over quickly what I have in my pack. This pack weighs about 30 pounds, including my camera gear and 2 liters of water for 4 days, food and all that stuff. So. Carrying my PFD on the outside on the portages right off the hop in this first little stretchy sleeve. Got my outdoor axe, Gransfors Brooks outdoor axe, great piece of kit. I've got the harness for my GoPro, my head mount for my GoPro. On the sides, I have my water bottle, which I need to fill up, my other water bottle, and I'm also carrying my tripod and my camera in that pocket. Lashed to the backpack on portages, easy access. On the other side, I've got my tent pegs, my tent poles and my pegs. In the very top, in the outside pocket, like I was saying the other day, I've got things I need to be accessed easily. My food for the day, my bug screen, bug head net, sunscreen, water drops, and then toilet paper. Obviously that needs to stay up there. I'm not digging through this thing, doing the old clench. So you open her up. This backpack's pretty cool. It's got a couple different closures, but got a buckle, then a draw cord. And this is how I've been packing. Primloft gets jammed in there because I'm gonna need it in the mornings. That's just slid down in the front. First off, this is things I don't want to have to use, like repair kit, sharpening kit, fire starter, stuff like that. This is camera gear. Maybe I'll go through that in a second. Very top, clothes. Next up, sleeping bag. Next up, tent. Sleeping pad. And the bulky one, food. So other than my loose stuff, and a bear bag. Other than my loose stuff, that's all that I have. This is my major equipment. It's not much, guys. Clothes, just spare clothes in case I get cold. Just a little bit of rope with the rope attached to the outside with the carabiner attached to the outside. Food, sleeping bag, sleeping pad, tent. That's it, man. That's all you need. Except for water, toilet paper, bug dope, stuff like that. Pretty straightforward this time. I packed way too much gear my last trip that I paid for it. So I'm treating this trip like it's a backpacking trip. Every ounce counts. The old Graham weenie. And I packed them in my backpack in that order on purpose. Food's heaviest. This is bulky and heavier than my tent. My sleeping pad is heavier than my tent. Get that. And then this big, soft, lofty sleeping pad on the top, or sleeping bag on the top. So all the weight on the bottom. I got a whole lot of questions on my last video about what I'm using to charge and what kind of camera gear I'm using and all that stuff. So in here is my camera stuff. I've got also like a little ShamWow towel in there. But other than that, it's all camera stuff. So I have 4 DSLR batteries, 3 in here. One is being used right now for my Nikon D5500. I have an 18 to 140 lens, kit lens on it. So that's my main camera, right? Those are my 3 plus my one in there batteries. I've got a GoPro Hero 4 Silver, which is attached to the canoe right now, with 2 batteries. This is the extra battery. And then I bought this little tiny charger. I should be able to charge my GoPro a couple times with this. And then that's the GoPro cord to it. I unfortunately cannot charge my DSLR this way because there's no USB. I have a 32 gig memory card in my DSLR right now, and I also have an extra 16. I have, apart from the head mount that I showed you, I have a little Joby pod for my GoPro, and then the GoPro mount that is on the canoe right now that you've been seeing shots from. Oh, and a little notebook. I guess I should mention, because somebody's gonna ask, I do have a pocket knife and a fire steel attached to me the whole time, all the time out here, and I have a Bic lighter. So my pocket has a zipper, my pocket knife has a lanyard, my fire steel has a lanyard. No losing those things. I'm gonna try not to lose anything on this trip. What a novel idea.
I heard a whole bunch of bullfrogs when I was paddling up here, and I hope I'm gonna get a chorus of them tonight. I've had the spring peepers, and those are great, but bullfrogs, man, there's something about bullfrogs I really like. We don't have them back down where I am anymore. They got all wiped out, which is really bad because frogs are an indicator of health. Let's climb that.
Spot, guys. I've never seen so many dragonflies either in one spot, so hopefully
That means there won't be many bugs. Those guys are awesome at keeping the bugs down. Yeah. I'm liking this spot quite a bit.
Gonna go get some firewood. It's about 2 o'clock now. Nice and early, I got some energy right now because I sat and relaxed. So yeah, off to find some firewood.
Cameras within cameras within cameras.
It's all conifers here. Balsam fir, by the looks of it. Not the greatest firewood. Ooh, a privy. It's a poop box.
Got a leaner here, dead. Give her one or two little chops to help it push over. Or six. So I worked out the hours and the kilometers done yesterday and today. Yesterday I did 18 kilometers total with 5-ish kilometers of portage. And it took me 8.5 hours. Today I did 13 kilometers total with about 1,600 meters of portage, and that took 6 hours. Tomorrow, I have about 18 kilometers of travel. I didn't add up portages yet tomorrow. Oh yeah, I did. It's about 5,500. So 18. So it's about the same as yesterday. Tomorrow. Today, I didn't even mean today for today to be a short day. And I guess if I would have paddled down into Trout Lake like I planned, it would have taken another maybe 2 hours, depending, not even, about an hour. And I would have got there at about 2. So it would have been a short day, regardless. But it's kind of nice. It's kind of nice to sit here, relax. I haven't set up my my tent or anything yet, just in case somebody has reserved this site and they come by. But like I said, I highly, highly doubt that that's the case. It's cool. There's no bugs here. Like, I hear flies, not black flies, but like actual flies. They're buzzing around, but they're not doing anything. Zero black flies, zero mosquitoes right now. There is a nice breeze cutting through here. I am surrounded by marsh, so I'm just kind of concerned that at night, the mosquitoes are just gonna go crazy and come out and eat me alive, but I'll have a fire. I'll wear my head net if it's necessary. So, yeah, pretty relaxed, man. I took a little snooze on the log. I do have to do some camp chores. I want to fix up this fire pit. It's not really ideal, the shape of it. I got to get some kindling. I've got to
Oh, I want to rehydrate my food right now. I want to let it sit for a couple hours while it's rehydrating, and then when it comes time to eat it, I'll just warm her up and call it good. All right, ready to start this. Just like with a normal fire, I've got all my prep laid out, my tinder, my kindling, my fuel, different stages. I'm gonna light some shavings with the fire steel. So, I like to get that going first with little twigs, and then once it burns down a touch where I can put the lid on, I do. Like this. I'm just gonna move that one piece out of the way. There we go. And then I'll put my pot on, and then I know how much room I have to stick twigs and fuel in there. The thing's pretty good, man. It keeps going nice and easy, so makes life easy out here. Finding twigs is super simple. I suppose I could come into problems if it had been raining for a few days, but in that case, I have fire starter that I can light and put in there and dry out the fuel, or I can always split down wood and do a split wood fire. Twigs are so much easier though. I'll let that boil up. What's for supper on night two? This is my suppers that are left. Two of them. Since last night I had my shepherd's pie, which is similar to the ground beef and rice and stuff, which is, I guess, potatoes instead of rice, a little bit different. I'm probably gonna go with my chili tonight. This is my last supper left over from last trip. So, now that the water's nice and hot. Ooh, smells like dehydrated chili. Just pour it right in. To help when I'm hanging my bear bag, I like to throw a rock inside my bag. Gives it some weight and lets it throw a lot easier. This white pine here is an ideal tree to hang a bear bag from. It's got everything I want to look for in a tree. So you've got right next to the water, the ground slopes down that way, and we've got, I don't know, 25 feet up high, a big branch that can support my food. And then I can hang it a good 6 feet out of, away from the tree there. It's the same one right there. This is the exact same one. I followed him over here. I don't know if it's coming through in the camera, but
all I can hear is buzzing, and it's from flies. Buzzing, bullfrogs, and dragonflies. I think I'm gonna go take a paddle down the marsh, see what I see. There are tadpoles jumping everywhere around me. Little fish too. Okay, I found something. Going up to it now, it's a skeleton. Gotta be of a fish. What? What the heck is that? Oh my goodness, look at the feet on it. Bird? Frog? I think that's a big bullfrog skeleton. All right, intact almost. What the heck? Look at the feet on it. I think they look like bird feet almost. There's the head. What the heck? Look at the size of the foot compared to my hand. It's gotta be a big bullfrog, man. The joint on it. It's big, dude. Crazy. If anybody can confirm or deny that is a bullfrog skeleton, I'd like to hear. If it's not, I'd be interested to see what it is. Some crazy looking flower. What is that? It's growing in a bog. And there's two others. There's nobody out here. The moon's out. Three quarters of a moon. Pretty relaxing out here. This is like the perfect day. The perfect camping day. I got up and busted my butt to get here. Got here early. It's just no bugs. No bugs? Are you kidding me? I'm liking this whole solo canoe thing. This whole solo canoe tripping thing. So much easier in this boat. I can get so much farther. I've never been able to go distance by myself in a canoe. So the consistency is about perfect. It's barely warm. I hand sanitized my hands when I got back after touching that bullfrog skeleton. It was a little juicy still. So, yeah, I have to warm this back up because I can't eat it lukewarm. Actually, cool. I would call that cool. I'm constantly stirring because now that there's no actual water in here, it's all rehydrated food, it would burn if I don't continuously move it. So I'll do this for a couple minutes until it's hot. It's almost done. I have been doing it for a couple minutes already. All right, I'm gonna eat this.
You know what it looks like.
I am full.
Little guy lost his head. Hello.
Oh. Okay, so this was here on this stump. Another little head. What the heck is that from? Is that a frog too, though? It's got teeth on it.
So this is a fish head, right? Obviously. But what is this? Is this a bullfrog head? Or a different type of fish? And look at the teeth on it. Can I get it in there? Like an alligator, or like a piranha looking teeth. There.
I think it's safe to say nobody's coming for this site today. Feels like a no tent fly kind of night tonight. Things may change later, but for now, that's what we're going with.
Being surrounded by bullfrog calls. There's like three patches of them. One over there, one behind me, and one that way. One will start, and the other ones will chime in. I love it. It's a beaver. I guess I didn't need to tell you what it was. There's his house right there. And he slapped the water probably like right around there. Elaborate. Beaver mansion. With second entranceway. Private drive.
Got some old pine knots full of resin. Throw those bad boys in there too. Just for funsies, you know? Just for funsies. Oh, that camera angle's a little lopsided. I promise I haven't started drinking yet. So I've got, this is a Mickey, which is 375 mils. I drank from there to there yesterday, and if I drank from here to here tonight, I'm gonna have from there to there tomorrow. just a touch less than three fingers worth. And three fingers is the daily allotment. Cheers. This one's to all you guys, all my faithful subscribers, all you guys who watch all my videos, comment or not, mean comments or not. This one's for you. Stay on top of the water. Don't get too dehydrated from it. Use it as a chase. Goes down easier for me that way. Drinking 40 Creek premium barrel select. It's Canadian whiskey from Grimsby, Ontario. So on my big trip with Kyle, I had this one, but it was called Copper Pot, 40 Creek Copper Pot. It was like a different version of 40 Creek. It's pretty good whiskey. No bugs, guys. I don't understand it. I don't get it, how there's no mosquitoes and no bugs here. This is the most marshy, low water, marshy, hummocky kind of camp I've ever been at. And I was expecting to be overrun by mosquitoes here. I was expecting night to fall and there would just be a ton of mosquitoes. There's no bugs. There's no bugs. Do you hear me?
Alright folks, day two in the books. Feeling good, ready for bed, looking forward for tomorrow. A high kilometer day, lots of work, but that's what I want. I'm gonna go to sleep listening to bullfrogs and birds with no rain fly on my tent. You guys have a good night and I'll see you in the morning.